Hey, hello everybody. So Reggae on the River is coming up real soon, and I want to talk to you all about what kind of camping gear you can bring that doesn't take up a lot of room and will greatly improve your experience. So I go up to Reggae on the River since 2005, and over the years, you know, every year you learn what's good, what's bad. And so my first year up there I went, and my friend Dave dragged me up, and I heard about it for years, and always put it off. I don't know why, because once I actually did it, it was a lot of fun. But it's 4 days of camping, and if you're used to the city life, 4 days of camping is kind of rough. Didn't have shade structure. All I had was a tent, an air mattress, and a sleeping bag, and my tent was not under shade, and that was pretty rough. And no shower except for hopping in the river for 4 days, so that was pretty cool. And the first year, I look across the way and these people have like a little shower tent. And I think they were using it as a bathroom or a shower, I'm not sure what it was. I tell my friend, oh, regular was great, except the only problems about it was, going to the bathroom's a little bit rough and, no shower. He said, and I told him about the shower tent, I said, well, why don't you get one of those, man? No problem. And so the one they had was pretty fancy and was a little bit of money, and I wasn't sure I wanted to spend that kind of money. So the one I got is really simple, and you can see right here it looks like a giant sunshade, basically. So I won't assemble it here. We'll skip to another segment and I'll show that. But basically it's like a giant sunshade, and it has a plastic hoop inside of here, and it springs from this. You see how compact that is? To this enormous, it's got to be at least this wide by that wide and over your head. It's not the strongest thing in the world. You got to like kind of stake it down, but it's an awesome tent. It's kind of not the thickest material, so I kind of like put a tarp around the corner of my canopy, and then that kind of gives a little extra shade, so it's not like you with the sun streaming through and like your silhouette of you taking a shower. Anyway, so these simple things right here, with what you see right here, I can go to the bathroom, I can take a shower, I can wash my hands very comfortably. So if you want to add to this a cook stove and a little pot and a top, then you can boil the water that's going to go in your buckets, and that would let you have a hot shower, a hot pressurized shower out in the middle of nowhere, anywhere. So the next purchase I did was, it's called the Luggable Lube, and it's just really a simple 5-gallon bucket. And then what they've done is they've supplied a little lid, and it's just your standard toilet seat. So it's not the most comfortable thing in the world, but I'll tell you, when your choice is this or a porta potty that 1,000 other people have used and not used it nicely, you'll be really happy to have this. So what you end up doing is you buy the Luggable Lube, and the nice thing about camping gear is this is a big empty volume. So what I do is inside each bucket, you know, I use binder clips for all kinds of things, clipping things to my canopy. So I put that inside. So any empty volume, you fill up. So this is a clean bag, and I always double bag it. Two bags, just in case something happens. Toilet paper, I bring baby wipes. And it's about the nicest going to the bathroom experience you can have in the woods. So what you do, put a bag, put another bag. You pop the seat in place, and then you go do your business, everybody knows. The only thing complaint I would have is the seat is not quite as big as a full-size seat, but you know what? You're in the woods. What are you going to complain about? You don't have an RV. So then when you're done, you don't have to touch anything. I know you're all like, wow, that's gross. And you know what? There's people, two kinds of people in the world. People who have gone to poop in a bucket, and then those who haven't. So, you know what? Who knows how they did it a couple thousand years ago, right? So when you're done, you grab from way on the bottom, and you got this big old bag, and you bring it up, and you tie it up, and you don't have to touch anything, okay? And then you wash your hands when you're done. you know, I like to go ahead and double bag it, and then you got to get that in garbage immediately, because you'd be amazed, even inside of two bags, how quickly that's going to start smelling. So that is a toilet. So I want to say, you know, I'll try to put a link for this guy right here. It's probably gone up. I want to say it was like, you know, $20 or something when I bought it, you know, 15 years ago. So that's the toilet. So what I'll do is I'll get my tent set up. This will be in the tent with me. And this, in addition to, you know, going to the bathroom, you can sit on it. It becomes a stool. If you're taking a shower, I put all of my shampoos and soaps on top of this. And, you know, since it's plastic, the water's not going to get inside because it makes a good seal. And it makes a good table for while you're taking a shower. So the next thing I'd like to show you is this guy right here. And this is cool, and I can't take credit for this myself. In the first place I saw this was Adventure Van Man. And Adventure Van Man basically showed you how you could take a weed sprayer, and that's the weed sprayer up to here. Then I cut off the hose that had the wand part, and I went to my hardware store. This side is a barb. And then this side is threaded with the, I think it was like 3/8, probably, something like that, so that I could put on a basic sink sprayer. So this would be a pull-out sink sprayer for a kitchen sink. And it works great. The last one I had was kind of fancy and had a little swivel on it. And the little plastic swivel broke on me. And actually, the two times I tried to take this and use this at Reggae, it didn't work quite correctly. So I'm hoping this time it's going to be a champ. So the first thing I forgot to do, this is a barb in here, right? And it fit fine the first time. But slowly but surely, you know, it's going to expand a little bit. And when I pressurized this, it started spraying out of here because I didn't have a hose clamp on it. So first fix was to get a hose clamp. Yeah, I put some Teflon tape here, but did not hose clamp it here. So every time I pressurized it up, it was leaking water and pressure out of here, which is okay. Because I'll tell you, the first, you know, when we get around to the demonstration of the shower, you don't need this. A simple cup, you know, like a 24-ounce, 32-ounce cup, you'd be amazed what you can do. You just scoop out of a bucket, and you put your hand up in the air, and you start at the highest point. It goes down, do your head, do the other hand. And with 5 gallons, you can take a fantastic shower. And if you're willing to take the time to warm up the water, it's about the nicest experience you can have out in the woods without having a plumbing. So anyway, cut off the wand, put on the sink sprayer, make sure you get a clean bug sprayer. This had never been used. My original plan was you can use this in the automotive to fill fluids. So then, I used it for camping, so you just fill it with your hot water. Pop that in, close it up, pressurize it up, and it makes a pretty good spray. I'll go ahead and we'll do a demonstration of it later on in the video, but real simple. And then here again, you know, $20-$30 for, I'll say it was probably about $30, and again, I bought this years ago and then repurposed it. Make sure you use a clean one, though, that hasn't been used for insect poison. Then let's get to the next part. Basic 5 gallon buckets. Where did I get these from? I think Osh, Home Depot, whatever. They all sell 5 gallon buckets. So why do I have 2 5-gallon buckets? Because what I found was 5 gallons is right on the edge of what you need to take a shower by yourself for one person. And then the other thing is, when I used to do this with a cup, you know, you'd soap up and you'd find you'd have soap on your hand, and you'd be amazed how little soap into clean water clouds it up and makes that water look contaminated. So what I would do is I would have one bucket for clean water, and I'd have another bucket to kind of rinse my hands off, get them clean, before I would put my hand in the clean water. Because, like I said, just even a little bit on your hand, and you put it into that clean water, and it looks like you've completely soaked up the water. So anyway, 2 buckets and a cup is really all you need for a shower. And then if you want to step up from there, you warm up your water with your cook stove. You want to step up from there, you get this, And the other thing I saw was, I think it was Enigmatic Nomadic, he used a stainless steel bug sprayer. So you can literally just set this thing directly on the stove, heat the water up in here. Only thing he said is you had to pull the plunger so it wouldn't melt, because it has some rubber gasket in here. So that wouldn't melt. But if you're willing to spend a ton of money, but these are folks who are like living out of their vans and they use that shower every day for a long time. So it was like a stainless steel is going to be $100-$200. So this was more like $30. So anyway, that's where we're at. Next thing I'll do is I will put this all together. I will open the tent up. I'm not going to do that in here though, because I've taken this on, 2005. So that's a long time of this has been deployed on the ground, dirty, getting it wet with soap and whatever. So we're not going to put that on our carpet here. So anyway, that's it. You see how compact this is. What I will do is there's a little airspace right here and I'll fill that with camping supplies. And then there's a little airspace right there. I'll fill that with camping supplies. I fill this completely full of camping supplies. That goes in like that. This here, I'm even thinking I'm going to open this up, and whatever I can fit in there that I can get back out of there, I might go ahead and do that, just so I'm not, you know, I have a Toyota Corolla, and you have to fill a Toyota Corolla up to the brim to camp for 4 days and have a relatively decent time. So anyway, we'll end it right here, and then the next step is I'll show everything assembled and give you an idea of how I use it.
Hello everybody, here's part two here. So I want to show a little bit about kind of how I set up the tent and everything. So this one's real easy. And then the fancier ones have kind of poles and structure to them. And this one's not as, I don't know, won't stand up to as much wind, I guess. But I kind of put it inside my canopy and then in a corner and then kind of clip it to the canopy to give it a little more structure. Ready to go. I'm waiting for the year that it doesn't go back in a bag. So it can't be easier. Inside here. So first of all, you can see how roomy this is, right? You feel like you're in your own little home. You just kind of zip yourself up inside of here. And then what I do, I put the buckets, you know, there's corners here, it's meant to be staked down, but I don't necessarily feel it needs to be staked down, especially when I have, you know, when you get 5 gallons of water in there, that's over 40 pounds of water. So and I usually keep water with me. You know, it's good to have 5-10 gallons just sitting around the camp, just in case a fire breaks out, you can get it going out real quick. Because I remember one Reggae on the river, it actually was a fire, and I was amazed at how quick that thing spread. Not in my camp, but somebody else's. This stuff, when it goes up impressively. So anyway, like I said, toilet will sit in here. Use this as a table when I'm taking a shower. These will be filled with water. One of them will have hot water that I have warmed up in a, you know, on a cook stove. So just while you're making your breakfast, you just kind of boil water, pour it in. So sit here, boil water, pour it in, refill it, put it back on the stove. Gets boiling, pour it in, refill it. And you have to do that for, I would say almost an hour. I'll like do a morning workout. Make breakfast, and then it's ready to go, and then I'll take my morning shower. So anyway, what we have here is we'll pour the warm water in there, put that in, spin it, sorry. Let's put you right there. Spin that. And you just gotta, let's see if I can hold this with my legs while we pressurize. There we go. Crotch cam. The idea. It's not the easiest thing in the world, but man, you have a pressurized shower out in the middle of nowhere, wherever you're at. What are you complaining about? Okay, that's gonna be enough. So, I won't do it in here. I don't want to make a mess out of this thing, but let's take this back out of here. So we'll show, you know, look at that. That's like 7-8 feet up in the air. And you know what? I know that's not super impressive, but you take a super efficient shower and you're going to use the 2.5 gallons. See? Still has pressure. Now it's kind of lazy. Let's see how much of a difference it makes if I really pump this up. Impressive, but it works all the way over your head, 6 feet in the air. And if you know anything about pumping air, water 6 feet up in the air, that's impressive. See that, how that works? It's a little bit of effort, but you have a semi-pressurized shower out in the middle of nowhere with no batteries, most importantly. And as long as you have a supply of water, you can take a shower every day, twice a day, three times a day, whatever you wanted to do. You don't even have, if you can tolerate cold shower, you just don't even have to warm up the water. So anyway, that's the insect sprayer. This is the shower enclosure. This works awesome. So that's how you be the cleanest hippie at, I should say, the cleanest dirty hippie at Reggae on the River. So anyway, it's an idea of like a small amount of things you can bring. You saw how compact that was and how much it kind of expands out to. It just feels like a whole room. And it is. You're basically bringing a whole bathroom with you in three little buckets, that, and a sunshade, basically. So the last thing I'll do is I'll show you breaking this back down. I'm not kidding, it's just that easy. Whoever came up with this is genius. I mean, it's starting to fall apart, like on the bottoms I didn't show you. It's starting to fray. And we're getting pretty close to a Reggae where it's gonna fall apart on me. I'll have to duct tape it together for the Reggae that I'm there to make it work. All See that? Look at that. It's all ready to go back in my car and leave Reggae or camping or wherever. Or if you're living in your car, look at that. So that's really easy. So anyway, that's a real nice little small luxury upgrade you can do for yourself. Any camping trip. I've been using this 2005, so I bought it like 2006, let's say. Took it on a bunch of Reggae's. I went to, and just before the kids were born, I went on first kid, three Reggae's, three different Reggae festivals just before the kid was born, because I knew it would be a few years till I could go again. But anyway, so yeah, you can see how easy just a couple little simple things. They're so compact that actually you could fill other stuff inside of that. You could put other stuff inside of that, and it doesn't take up much room. So anyway, that's how you be the cleanest dirty hippie at Reggae on the River. Thank you for tuning in. Please like and subscribe. Thank you.